now for some... I was doing my own artistic precision there. Time now for some artistic precision. Chisels, a mallet and 5 decades of dedication.
That's the world of Clive Fugill, one of our most accomplished Māori carvers whose only wish is to pass on the mastery of his forebears. Here's Michael Holland.
It's as much what you hear as what you see. Delicate yet deliberate, as it has been for Clive Fugill for a remarkable 52 years.
Every day you want to come back to work to find out how the next stage of it's going to go. Still enjoy it. Yeah, still enjoy it. It's a passion. Everyone just calls me Chiefy.
Chiefy?
I don't know how I got Chiefy, but...
A compliment?
Oh, I think so. I'm quite honoured to be called Chiefy.
Chiefy Clive picked up his first chisel as a child.
I'd say to myself, hell, that's what I want to do.
And has been at the National Māori Arts and Crafts Institute since his late teens.
In 1967, I was in the first intake of students that came into the school.
16 years later, he was bestowed the coveted position of the Institute's Master Carver.
Put one in there.
The lead instructor of a select group of students, as he once was.
He's dedicated his whole life to this kaupapa. Gave me my hands.
Gave you your hands?
Yeah.
You're putting the skill into the hands. It's the skill factor.
Those decades worth of skills and nurturing, recognised with the supreme accolade at the New Zealand Institute of Designers Awards.
Probably the crown and glory in my career.
Well, there's a whole lot of emotions in here. The wood itself, where the wood comes from. The totara tree, one of the children of Tāne, the guardian of the forest. I always say, it's how difficult you make the work, not how easy you make it. That's where the challenge is. How can I best get that cut done? Will it work?
What do you see on his face?
Patience, experience, and just love and passion for this art form.
Tough question. In your mind, how good are you?
Well, I've never ever considered myself to be a good carver. Some of these guys in here technically are better than me. And I'm quite happy to say that, because I don't really have an ego as such. I'll pick up things from these guys I've never heard before. Oh, never heard that before. That's good. I'll have that.
Presiding over his labours, three treasured ancestral works from the 1870s.
These carvings here are inspiration for us, the perfection and what they did at that time.
When you set a new piece of wood in front of you,
yeah,
you can still be invigorated?
Oh yeah, yeah. Because when you look at that piece of wood, you see the end product in there. As my old master used to say, you see that door over there, boy? Yes. The day you can imagine 100 different patterns in that door is the day you're a carver. Most people would look at me and say, oh, but he's not a Māori. But here's where they're wrong, because there's my Māori side. That's my great, great, great grandmother. She married a European. I never stopped learning.
Watching you work, I think your quiet patience matches your gentle disposition.
It's just who I am, I guess. Yeah.
Am I right?
You'd be right, yeah, probably right. Yeah.
Beautiful, Clive, just beautiful.
You do have to have a lot of patience though, oh, right? Yeah.
Incredible skill.
I couldn't do it.